Hello and welcome to the show. I am back today on Scrap Mechanic looking at a wonky tree. Hold on, I've been distracted. What on earth has gone on with that tree? The fact they're all broken. What have I done? It wasn't my fault, honest. Have the trees always been this wonky? I don't know. Well, there's a new mystery. Anyway, I have been immediately distracted. We're building stuff today. Yeah, I'm going to try and build a crazy, crazy high-performance tractor. And that's very ambitious, because so far, my previous track records of building stuff is this monstrosity of a sled. It works, it does the job, and the currently broken toilet trailer that'll get fixed. I messed up the suspension. It'll get fixed at some point. However, yeah, we're going to build a really rather technical thing for my skill level. You've got to bear in mind this is my skill level we are talking about, and this is going to be quite a technical undertaking. Now, I could kind of build with these beams, in all honesty, part of the tractor chassis that we're going for, the style of tractor that we're going for here. These sort of beams would actually probably work quite well. For ease of use, though, for now, we might go around and beautify it later. We're just going to use these blocks. It makes building much easier when we have these blocks. I'm actually also going to build this one properly, and I'm going to have a center line for it, rather than... yeah, the cock-ups that we have had previous. Now, the tractor that I'm going for is not a normal tractor, okay? We're not building a normal-style tractor here. We are going for the... Now, about three of you are probably going to know the sport tractor pulling. And we're going for a vehicle based on those. It is a crazy, crazy sport that I haven't seen for many years. You're probably wondering how on earth did I even know about it. When I was growing up, unlike most kids who watch cartoons and so on, I watched British Eurosport. And at the time, that showed a lot of tractor pulling and a lot of truck trials, for anyone that knows what that is, essentially rock crawling with trucks and so on. And yeah, many hours were spent watching this sort of stuff, hence why I know about, admittedly I know about it from like 20 years ago, but yeah, we're going to build a crazy tractor to, well, probably wheelie and fall over and maybe pull the toilet trailer at some point in the future. Now, I'm trying to figure out, see, I was thinking I wanted 5 wide, but I'm not actually sure I do now. I'm thinking I might want 3 wide for the front bit, so we're going to have kind of like a long front bit with some wheels on, some tiny little wheels on. And then we have a much, much wider back bit where the driver would sit. Is 3 going to be wide enough? I don't know. Now I'm not sure. I am not sure at all. We've got to worry about some form of steering. Now, of course, admittedly, these things wouldn't have the greatest of steering in the world. We don't have a bearing as something already down here. Suspension was, I'm actually going to try and get clever with the suspension at the back of the vehicle. We'll come to that later. For the front though, we're not really worrying about anything suspension wise because they don't have anything. They're not designed to steer particularly well, so yeah, we're not going to go massively complicated in terms of front suspension, front steering. What we're going to do is, do we want to, in fact I've got it on a blooming lift. I will remember eventually that we got it on a lift. I don't even know if we want to come out this far, to be honest. We do need to come out far enough so that we can get some movement on the damn thing. So we will do that, and then we will do that. Is that how far down we want it to come? We might actually not want it to come down that far at all. We'll have a look. We'll stick these on here, and this on this side there. In fact, I could have just built straight... Oh, no, I couldn't build straight out, sorry, because I've got to have the steering from the bearing in there. And then we will go for small wheel. I think that's the smallest one that we have as an option there. It's a relatively sizable wheel. However, it's going to be nothing compared to the wheels we're going to have at the back, because I have gone and found a mod for it. So, that's going to be our front. We're basically going to have no real suspension at the front. This is literally so that there can be some movement in the steering. That's all. That's all the front of this is for. That's all the front of this needs to be doing. And I might just go... no, of course, can't do that, can I? Because that will stop the thing from moving. Right. That'll work. It's a little bit wider than perhaps I would ideally like. I think that going for 3 wide sort of main chassis was a good call. Now, what we are going to do down here... Actually, what we could do is we could then build it up, kind of make it a little bit of a tub. Because essentially, all that we're going to have in the top here is just engines. It's just going to have engines. I say engines. It's going to have maybe a couple of the game's engines, but we're going to try and build it up to look like it has. I mean, the actual tractors have got... I think some have got like 3 or 4 engines on them. And we're not talking small engines here either. They're ridiculous. So, yeah, if we kind of build it like that a little bit... And then we can fit some stuff in here. We've got various things that I can use to make look like. I was just experimenting very briefly before I started recording. Things like this that we can kind of use to make it look like. I think they're supposed to be wires, but that we can make them look like engine parts and so on. I actually quite like that. That's quite cool. That will work wonderfully. Oopsie daisy. Of course, because these were connected to the ones the other side. It's fine. I didn't just delete something stupid. Well, I didn't delete something stupidly. I deleted something that I meant to delete and something fell off that I wasn't quite prepared for, but never mind. Right. Distraction aside, we're going to have to try and build up the back of this. Now, I'm not quite sure how wide I want the back of this to... Ooh, hello, camera. What are we doing there? Ah, it's because we've rotated it funkily. How wide are we going to want? Because we've got to bear in mind that the wheels are going to come out wider because I'm going to try and build fancy chassis stuff, basically. Have I got this right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at that, some guesswork from me. Oopsie, wait, we wanna go that way, there we go. The more I'm building with this game, the more I like it. I've gotta say, the more that I'm messing around with the tools, I think it's a really nice intuitive way of building and so on. We're probably gonna extend this. I'm not really caring much about the size. We're kind of just going for it. Now, that's gonna kinda be a basic sort of thing that we've got going on, because the wheels are going to probably stick out. Actually, maybe what we'll do, now just having a think, the wheels are going to take up most of the width, because the wheels we've got are massive, so I don't actually know if I need to build this back chassis any wider. We might just extend it further back as the 3 wide. There we go, whoopsie, and we'll have the same problem with the seat that we had before, because the seats are too wide. I think someone said there was a 1 wide seat. I guess we could have the motorbike seat. I don't know if we can change like the size of these or something, or maybe there's a mod for it, because yeah, the seat is a pain in the ass, really. Let's get rid of the bathtub. We're not going to need a bathtub on our tractor. Because, yeah, the seat is too wide, unless there is a way of changing it. Which, as far as I know, there isn't. Can we get up here? I just want to just kind of do a demonstration game. Game. Behave yourself now. Oopsie. Bugger it. It's not... Okay, yeah, it won't even go in there, but it's not going to sit nicely. That's a pain in the ass. Does that do the job? That will do the job. Okay, so it might have a little bit of an odd seating position, but we're not going to worry about that too much for now. Although, again, maybe we'll make it one bit wider. So if we have it there, have it at that width, then we can have the seats. The seat's never going to be central, though, because we've made it... we've made an uneven amount so that we can have the... toe hitch in the middle, but then we got, yeah, never mind, we're not going to worry about that. We're not going to worry about that, it's not important at this moment in time. As I said, we are going to try something, I'm going to try something a little bit different with the suspension at the back here. We're going to try and get it to have slightly more realistic suspension, but I don't know how well this is going to work for me. Basically, the plan is we're going to try and give it a bit more sort of realistic movement in terms of the suspension, and I've been racking my brains as to how on earth I can get this to work. I was hoping there was going to be a lever so that we could kind of mount it on this. I don't know how on earth I'm going to describe it to you either. But basically, what we're going to do is we're using the bearings here, and I don't even know quite what height we want the bearings here and here for now, I guess. And we might have to take that block out there so that doesn't connect to anything. So that these can rotate, and we can have some movement in it. Now, I've just got to try and figure out what I want my... how I want my suspension to be compressing and doing things. I'm not even sure if I need 2 of these at the moment. I was going to kind of try and go for a sort of double wishbone-y style suspension, but I don't think I'm clever enough to figure that one out. We also have the slight issue that without mods, suspension is only ever vertical. I don't think there are ways you can make the suspension go at an angle. So we have to kind of deal with vertical suspension. We will go for some off-road suspension on this one. So if we were to then place that there... Now, this might have to start off a lot higher up. I've just realised why this might start a lot higher up. Because we've then got to put a block down here, like so, to put the bearing on. like that, and then we have the wheel. So as I said, we've got some massive wheels for this, because if we go in for a tractor pulling style tractor, we've got to have much bigger wheels than we were working with. So we've got huge terrain wheel wide. This is the one that we are wanting. And it is a huge bug. That's even bigger than I was expecting. Okay, that might actually be a little too large. Okay, let's go. Come back. Large terrain wheel wide. Let's try that one. That's maybe. Is that any smaller? Okay, let's have another look. Medium. Let's have a look at medium terrain wheel. I know they said that these were tremendous wheels. That was literally the name of the mod, was tremendous wheels. They are certainly. That might actually be a better. Sort of scale-wise for this, because, yeah, the size that we've got. Now, the tractor is going to be kind of nose down, that's the point. He's going to look kind of dragster-esque, that is half of the point. Now, the problem I have is I need kind of ways of limiting this, because the bearing's just going to rotate, and that's just going to go straight up, and it's going to drag itself along the floor. How do I limit the movement that bearing can do? Without doing the horrendously ugly, like, I can cheat this, and I say cheat this, we can do, like, a little system whereby if we come across here, and then maybe if we build up one, like, build, like, something like that, it would then stop the suspension from going too far up. But it isn't particularly a pretty system. I had a great idea, and now my brain is trying to figure out how to actually make said great idea. This is often the problem with my great ideas. I have these ideas, and then they just don't quite work. How high up does that come? So if we have that sort of sit up there, it is on this level here that we want to build the suspension. So, oh no, wait, because we need to put the bearing on. Oopsie. Didn't quite want to get rid of it in that order, but never mind. Right, so if we put the bearing on there, there is definitely no way, as far as I can tell, to sort of set movement. So then that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Yeah, and then we stick on the suspension down there. We put a block at the bottom, like so. Then we put a bearing on the damn thing, and then a massive wheel on there. And we need to put sort of a block at the top, which will come out in this fashion. I'm just trying to make sure that it's symmetrical. Whoopsie. Kind of come out in that fashion, and then up over there. Like that, for now. Okay, let's just give this a test. If we drop that down, nah, it doesn't stop it. Okay, it doesn't stop it soon enough. It's the right kind of idea, but it doesn't stop the suspension from doing too much movement. Oh, I don't know how I'm going to deal with that. They're going to go crazy because they've not got any controller. That's fine. That's irrelevant for now. What if we were to... Okay, plan. If we were to move the suspension onto this point here... So we would have the bearings in this part rather than where they were. I'm just trying to think of leverage going on at the moment. If we were to have them... Oopsie, we need to move them one further back, don't we? Crap. Get rid of all of that. So if we have them on here... This is a really wonky way of doing suspension. I apologise to anybody who does know this game well, but I am doing things my way, as I often tend to do when it comes to games. I'm doing things my way, which is not always the best way. I've got to delete all of this crap, aren't I? Because, there is like a weld tool, isn't there? Now I come to think about it. So if we get rid of that, we get rid of that, and then we build that there, and then that there. Can I knock this wheel away? Okay, might have to... I just don't quite know how to... Because I need it to be that length, but I don't know how I'm going to weld... All right. That's how we do it. I'll remember all of the tools the game has to offer. A connecting tool? No, not connecting tool. It is called a weld tool. I found out I actually had it already out. So that go onto there. Oh, if we just stick that up. That onto there. That is then working. Okay, so hold on. I've got to recount again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So then over here, we have our suspension. Yep, this is working well, potentially. And then we put the block under there that we want. Stick that all back up again, and it will then completely collapse because it's not quite right. It's basically the way this is going to work. Right, if we just dump that out. That's not welded into there properly. Oh, for God's sake. I think I'm just trying to be too complicated, in all honesty, with this suspension. I think, as much as I like the... Why is it let go, then? I'm kind of confused there, because that's showing it all as being connected, but in there it doesn't weld it together properly. Oops. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do at all. That's what we wanted to do. Nope. Are we going to be happy there? There we go. Right, I managed to delete a block in here. Oh, wrong button again. I'll remember my mouse buttons eventually. Why is that not working in here? Is there too much stress on it? Does it snap it off because there's too much stress going on? Possibly. I'll try to be clever with suspension and it's really not working. I would be better off just forgetting all of that and going back to a normal system. Okay, well, I kind of gave it a try. There's a way of making that work. My brain is just not quite clever enough to figure it out. We'll get rid of that, though, because I don't want that, and I don't want that. Right. For now, it'll do. For now, it'll do. We will... if we just try to dump that off... Okay. It kind of looks the part. It does look the part. Okay, ignore the flappy wheels at the front. We might want to, if we go suspension resistance, well, maybe not quite that viciouser, but if we go for like 6 or something? Yeah, I'm liking it. I'm liking the start. We might want to just go a little bit lower. What if we go for like 4? Tell you what, the suspension on 3 is jelly and on 4 is actual suspension. So, 4 will do. 4 will do for now. Place creation on the lift. Right, now we're going to not worry too much about the suspension. What I want to have, do we have the bits to look the part? Kind of, yeah. Because what I want to do is, that might be a bit too small. Often these monstrosities have kind of like these giant mud flaps that go around the wheels that are very, very difficult for us. Oh, they're tiny. That's a lot tinier than I was expecting, I'll be honest. That was a lot tinier than I was expecting. So if we build from here-ish and then build out to maybe this one here we want to kind of build out at to kind of have cover the wheels. I was hoping that the pipes were going to be a little bit bigger. But unfortunately, they are not. So if we have it build up like this, and then kind of, I guess at this level, we're sort of wanting this to go on. If we can get the angles right, we can't get any lower than that, can we? Climb up on here then. Will it look right? Don't really know. We're just doing some guesswork as we go along. That tends to be the best way for all of my buildings. Nope. It doesn't look how I want it to. The duct might do the job. Possibly. How big is that? That's tiny again. Do we not really have any bigger sort of angled blocks? That's really annoying. That's really annoying indeed. We can't delete all of these in a nice big pattern. Bugger it. I should have probably gone and got some mods for doing this sort of thing. I was kind of expecting this to do the job. I was thinking that these would be a lot bigger blocks than they are. They are not at all. What if we were to try and spin it in a way that didn't look... There we go, that's the way that we want them to be in. And this kind of works. Kind of works. I mean, what we'll do is we would paint this side. I mean, this would be painted to... I think they often have like sponsors stuff on them and whatnot. So we would kind of build along there. Build out the other side as well. For now, that'll do though. We can paint it so it doesn't just look like bare metal. Unfortunately, yeah, that doesn't quite kind of curve up as much as I was hoping it would. Can we get that to point the right way? Never wants to go the way that you want it to. What if we were to then build along here? How would this look? not quite like that, but then that'll do. I was hoping for a better way of building it, but that it works at the end of the day. Kind of build it up like this. Oopsie, what have we done there? I mean, it kind of does the job. I'm kind of okay with it for now. It's, yeah, not the prettiest of work, but it kind of gets the point across. And then we want to go spin that round. I mean, at the end of the day, hell, I'm building my own vehicle, so if it wants to look weird, then it'll look weird. And I'm fine with that. I'm perfectly fine with that. I've never actually used the paint tool on this game. Paint tool, there we go. Shall we go and have a little bit of a faff around? I don't even know how to use it. Okay, I mean, that painted it. How do we change colour? How do we change colour of the paint tool? Press Q, that's how we do it. Oh, wait, hold on, no, come back. Of course, we've got to have the orange. That's kind of yellow. Is that going to be any better? So the orange and black mobile. It's not really, they're not really options that we can do. Oh, God, got to paint these individually. Okay, maybe it's not going to be the orange and black mobile, because we don't really have orange as a colour option. Blue? Sure, we'll have blue and white, I guess, as our colours for this. Typical, I've got to spray all of these. Can we just hold it? No, we can't hold it down. We've got to just mash click. Sure. This could be the colour of our racing tractor, I guess. Oopsie, we'll do the down this side as well. Oh, no, wait, that still is white. So we're going to want that to be blue. We will paint all along there. And so on. Yeah, I think it'll look the part when it's done. I mean, it will look the part badly built by me, so that's fine. Okay, I quite like that as a fender arrangement. It'll work. Shall we have a little go? Have a look. Oh, we're 20 minutes in. That's good. It's fine. It's actually taken me a little bit less time because I stopped pratting around with silly suspension layouts and have just got to the job of building. It hasn't quite taken as long as I thought it would, but that's because I've not really built it very well. I say I've not really built it very well. It'll do the job at the end of the day. And that's kind of the most important part. And then that bit up there can be painted blue. I'll have to do it from the outside as well. We'll worry about the front in a bit. Engine-wise, God's sake. I need a higher jump. We are going to, of course, be going for the gas engine. Now, we only really technically need one of these, as from what I've been told and from what I've experienced from playing the game myself, it doesn't make any difference if you have multiple engines. It doesn't get any more power, which is a little bit of a shame, but that's just the way that it's the way that it goes. So we do only technically need one, and these engines are probably not really going to be seen. I'm going to do it in a similar configuration, though, with the four of them as we had on our initial test sled, just because I like it. And it looks the sort of wonky that you would see on the tractor pullers. However, yeah, that's not really going to be the main thing, because what we're going to try and do is... I'm not sure we're going to cover them up per se, because I do still need to be able to access them a little bit. Shall we get a... I want to get a seat up. The reason why is I want to turn the engines on, and I want to make sure that the thing doesn't go haywire. Admittedly, they're not connected to anything. But where shall we sit? You do tend to sit very high up in these. So if we kind of sit up here when it comes back down... I'll try and build a roll cage sort of around the driver to do the job. Let's just go and... In fact, what we'll do... We'll connect everything up, and then we can see how it sits on the floor. So, oopsie daisy, that can go up to there, that can go up to there. So that should now stop it from spazzing out when we drop it. And drop. Okay. Actually really looks the part. I'm really pleased with it in that it does very much look the part. The steering's going the wrong way currently, however, that's fine. It's twisting a little bit on the suspension. Whoopsie, but that's okay. Do we want to stiffen up that suspension anymore? Maybe to 5? That has actually dropped a lot more than I was expecting it to, but I'm okay with that. Yep, that works. That actually works very well for me. I just wanted to check that before we go start stuffing other stuff into it, that was actually looking all good. How are we going to do the engines? Do we go for... I'm just thinking... Or how are we going to do the sort of the visual side of things? Because we are going to turn these on. Before we... In fact, now I've put the seat on and whatnot, these don't... of course, I haven't connected them to a wheel, so they're not powering stuff. It's fine, because these will... This seat will be controlling the engines. Do we try and fit on, like, four aesthetic-looking bits for the engine, or do we just go for, like, two massive engines, or I don't know. I'm not sure which way to go for, really. I guess two is probably going to be the easier. I just don't know if I like those down there, either. Nah, I'm not sure. Two is probably going to be easier, size-wise, if we were to have these... hold on, we've got to build along here a bit, haven't we? And then, kind of... does it need to be one higher? Maybe it does. Alright, let's get rid of all that. Get rid of all of... Nope! Piss, I've jumped off the tractor thing. I don't even know if it's really fair to call these tractors, to be honest with you, because they're far from conventional. Alright, we've got rid of that nonsense. If we were to build... Okay, let's try... If we were to build over here, cover those up. Then place on top. It's going to get really tall. But admittedly, these things are very, very tall as well. So if we were to then have that as a point at which to build up from with these, and then we were to have it sort of like so. Like there. Oh, wait, caught that one up there. Then these are technically wires. I don't know. I kind of working on the assumption that... There is a proper use for these, and I'm just using them stupidly. If we were to have this like that... No, we need to move that. Okay, right, plan. We'll move it all across one, and then it'll work. Yeah, I think we will be even. So if we move that across to there, get rid of that, and then have that there. Yeah, I think that'll work out how I want it to... Look, I'm not quite sure what we're gonna do with the underside of this just yet. We will worry about that when we come to it. Can we build that? Get up, climb, please. Thank you. Build that along to here-ish. Sure, we'll go for massive. We'll go for massive, massive engines. We'll go to. Why can we not go to? Oh, because I'm standing there. That probably explains why we can't go to there. Right, and then we will have that underneath. Over there. I don't know if there are any other cool blocks that we can have that will look the part or not. Oh, for God's sake. Build. No, not there. There. And I told you not there, goddammit. Yeah. Okay, I'm really liking these engines. Or these fake pretend engines. Oh, we've got to have like big turbine bits on the front as well, because that's all the cool tractor pulley ones have big turbine bits on the front. Oh, we could actually... the underside, what we could have is we could just kind of like piping. Yes, I like that idea. I like that idea. I haven't got big piping though. We need big piping. Ooh, large tank. Could that do the job? Oh, wow, okay. That's a lot bigger than I was expecting. In fact, the small tank is a lot bigger than I was expecting as well. Okay, that's not quite going to work. You see, we kind of got this weird thing where everything is either horrendously massive or piddly. We've got a small short pipe. Now we've gone the other extreme of we've gone tiny. Do we not have any medium-sized stuff here? Like at all? Because that's small pipe stuff. They're pipe parts. Table support? Could we retrofit that to do something different? It's not at all how I was planning on going with it. I quite like it, though. Yes, I want that. I want that around the side of my tractor. And then we still want some way of run. I want to run something along the bottom and run it to the back. What about... What is that? Oh, no, wait, we want five? See, now again, that's kind of got a little bit too massive. what else have we got in here? What's that? Is that going to be tiny? That's the question. Oopsie, I forgot. I've got to drag it down onto here. Quite like that, but I'm not sure quite where I can use it, because I don't know if I put it on... If we put it on there, because you see, I can put that coming out of that corner, but then we're going to have the rest of them at wonkies. Okay. I mean, I do kind of currently like this system we got going on. Again, as far as mechanical goes, I don't really care. It's not supposed to be an accurate representation of anything, really. It's just supposed to look cool. And I'm happy with this at the moment. That does have an extra layer down here, so that's what we're going to put in. Can I do it quickly and easily from anywhere? No, not really. Actually, it doesn't even matter, because if we just do that, no one's going to... Oh, no, you might be able to tell. Bugger, there's no actual good way of doing this. Crap. Can we... Click and drag from like there. Oh wait, maybe if we twist it the right way around we can. Aha. Right, so we'll do that. So then we'll put these pipes back in again. There we go, we'll attach to there. When I was talking about piping, I was thinking of having much different arrangement, but this works. Well, it's gonna have like a giant... There's some of the tractors that have like giant turbine engines that sit on the front, and we were gonna kind of have that down the side, but I can't get anything the right size, so this will do. When it says large pipe, how large is the large pipe? Bloody giant, of course it is. That's a pipe. Okay, let's try that one. If we can rotate that around at an angle that we want it to be at, that could work, kind of. I'm an idiot. Sorry. I was going to get rid of that one because I know that one's connected to the steering, and I forgot that, of course, everything is all connected to... to important bits. So if we have that there, then we kind of just run this along here. Unfortunately, I don't think there's any way to have it look like those go into these pipes, but it is kind of just doing the job. I will go around, of course, and paint all of it so it looks all the same color, and that can, whoopsie, that cannot go in there, that can go like that, and that can go like that, and for now that'll do. Okay. I'm actually quite liking my tractor so far. Let's go and paint. Let's just see what the paint tool will make of this. If we go for black for this, what would it's kind of exhaust-esque. It's not really proper full-on exhaust, is it? It's just kind of looking technical, and that's about it. As long as it looks vaguely about right, I am happy with that. Yeah. I'm liking it. I think what we'll also then go do, perhaps, for the... Can we go have... Oopsie, don't want that colour. We want sort of red for these. Ah, yes, it will kind of have, like, red engine bits. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to paint all of it red. Actually, no, I quite like that. That actually works out better than I was expecting it to. Because, yeah, we can't paint all of the, all of the wire bits in the right colour. But I'm actually quite pleased with the way that looks. Yeah, it's coming along really well. In fact, when I go from a distance, it actually looks how I half envisioned it. The suspension is crap. Well, I say crap, it's just generic. But that is really looking the part. Okay, it is about, 50% done, really. We've got to finish off the other side of the kind of fender area. We've got to work on a roll cage and, of course, get the thing driving and probably fiddle around with the suspension and power, etc. But... that crazy tractor is on the build, and I'm really happy with it. I'm actually really, really happy with the way that has turned out so far. That, though, is going to be it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.